Hello everybody and welcome back to the Gamer Donnie channel. I'm here on YouTube. I'm Gamer Donnie and we're going to play some American Truck Simulator. Today we are going from Montrose to El Paso, Texas with 46,297 pounds of tanks. Got the Western Star with the power hood. I got the C15 in it, 630 horsepower with just a regular 18 speed. So I've got about 591 miles to go. It's going to take us about 11 hours to get there. It's going to be about 30 minutes in game time. We're almost full. We're 10 gallons from being full. So we almost got a full load of fuel. We will have to stop and pick fuel up along the way. This is a John Rudess flatbed trailer here. That's what we're using. It's just called flatbed. So let's jump in this thing, get out of here, and get on the road. Alright, I do like we always do. This place is a little tricky to get out of if you don't know how to do it. It's not really all that hard, really. But it can be. Might just be better just to go out the entrance, but we're gonna go out the exit like we're supposed to do. The exit's right there. And we should be able to make that. And drop our axle back down, even though we don't need it, but we got it. Might as well use it. That's the trailer axle, by the way. It could be a little tight getting out of this spot right here, too. Little bumping and grinding in them and nothing. It's all good. But they put the bumper on there for, right? Right. You don't stay close to that wall, you're going to run your trailer up on the inside of that curve where the wall is. So, got to get too close to it as you can. Oh, 15 miles an hour speed limit. We do gotta go down and up the $1 million highway, which is just not that bad, really. It just the speed limit 25 going up, and it just takes so long. But we've done it many a time, so I don't see no reason why we can't do it again. I do like the fact that the hood moves separately from the cab. That's a pretty cool little feature. Must be something new they've added. I ain't never noticed that before on any other trucks, so. This is the same Western Star I had. I just added a big hood on it, and I had to change the paint job because my Gamer Donnie Trucking paint job, I got to update it because it puts the little logos where the mirrors are there on the side of the truck. I'm gonna put the little logo there too, just like on a door, so I gotta fix that. Big deal. I'm just gonna stretch it just a little bit, you know. Readjust it. How's everybody been doing out there in old YouTube lane? You guys been doing pretty good? Everything's going good here on my end, as always. I can get this video created and uploaded before the storm's rolling. It's gonna storm like hell here in about, I don't know, here pretty soon. Gear. Could have swore I hit the button. Up the hill we go. I believe this transmission is supposed to regular standard ratio in the rear end, which is a 3.55, which is the default ratio that all the SCS trucks have in them. But we do got a big old C15 under the hood, so pushing quite a bit of horses, especially for a light load like this. Might have to get rid of that noisy seat mod. It's alright, it gets annoying after a while. I thought we'd take the old Western Star back out again. I only drove it once when it first came out and did that video on the Western Star Big Hood. I do believe we had the heavy haul truck. That's what I made. I was going to go with the automatic transmission, but the only ones they had was the Allison 6-speeds. And I want something with a few more gears than that, especially if you're going to be climbing hills. More gears, the better. So we just went with the old nasty 18-speed. I'm using Project Next Gen, so 1.08.3 version of Project Next Gen. Project Next Gen is a graphics mod, and it enhances the graphics to a 4K/8K textures. Fucking bus, man. Holy shit, we almost took the whole front end of that thing off. I didn't want to go around the corners, turns, the corner of the nut bus sticks out into your lane. Gotta be paying attention. Make sure everything's working here. Recording, microphone's working, sound's working. I was going to do a live stream tonight. I might end up doing one anyway, even though it's supposed to storm. Red Mountain Mining Overlook. I ain't never been there. One of these days we'll stop and check it out. I keep saying that, but we're getting 2.7 miles per gallon. Well, this engine's by Z Mods too. I don't know if I mentioned that or not, but yeah, it's a C16-6NZ. I guess, right? That's right. I absolutely love Z Mod sound mods. They're just good, they're high quality, and they're well worth the dollar to you that they cost. Alright, 45 speed limit. Looks like we made it up the hill. Almost missed that gear there. Got to split the gear and I was going downshift. That's the reason you don't shift going downhills or uphills. It's not like driving your pickup truck. You need to just push the clutch in and stick it in the gear. It just doesn't work that way. Really, you only use the first inch or two of the clutch when you're shifting. If you're double clutching, you don't want to push that clutch all the way down. I got the clutch brake on it. That's the reason to put it in the first. You have that be stopped. You can't be moving, or it will not go in the first. Same thing was low. Keep left, 10-4. I like how they added a different color of trees. That's pretty cool. Welcome to Durango.
Go straight on. Go straight on.
I like the way this engine sounds. It sounds good with the truck. Some engines just do not go with the truck. They just don't. I don't know what it is. They just don't sound good together. Like a big C16, a fucking Volvo. No, that doesn't work. Not for me. Keep 50 right south.
And then turn right. Turn right.
Let's see, where are we heading? El Paso? We're in Durango right now. I don't believe. There might be an interstate that runs south go down there, on. But I think it's going to be pretty much two lane back roads. We'll be a little bit of interstate there around 40. We'll head east on it a little ways. We'll cut back south. Down through New Mexico. I ain't seen one of those in a long time.
Go straight on.
Usually we turn right there on the 160 west. Not today, not this time.
Go straight on.
Let's see. We want to stay in this lane. We're going to take a right turn up here. Around this next curve. Look good on fuel and everything. Yeah. Walmart.
Go straight on.
Been kicked out of many of Walmart parking lots for sleeping. I just delivered a damn load. You're not going to let me stay here and sleep? Shit. I mean, I can understand why they don't want it like that. The whole parking lot will end up filled with trucks, but you know, you just delivered a load there. I think you should be able to at least sleep there.
Keep right and then turn right. Turn right.
Nothing like getting woke up to somebody banging on the side of your fucking truck. Then they go, "Was you sleeping?" And I'm sitting here playing my fucking self. What the hell? I've never slept on ramps or off ramps or anything like that inside the interstate. I wouldn't be able to get sleep. I'd be too scared somebody's gonna plow down through there into me or something. One run into the back of me ended up dying. Not for me. So make sure you
and then turn right.
Make sure you do a good trip plan every morning when you wake up, or evening, whenever the hell you wake up.
Turn right.
But even still, if you do a good trip plan, you know, truck stops get full.
Turn left.
Always drove at night time though. That way, when it's time for me to go to bed, everybody's waking up and leaving. Don't have to put up with all the damn traffic and shit either. Wish these traffic lights were a little bit longer.
Go straight on.
Get out of these damn little cities and we'll make some time up. I ain't never drove a Western Star in real life. Just about everything else. Speed limit 70. Fuel mileage went up to 3.6 instead of 2.7. seen they posted some more about the Oklahoma DLC. Looking pretty good. I think American Truck Simulator is on sale on Steam. I think it's like $5 or $7, something like that. All the way up until July the 18th, I believe it is. But they're doing their summer sale. So if you ever been thinking about getting it, and didn't want to have to pay the full price, now would be a time to pick it up. About doing another convoy. I did one when I streamed on Twitch there for a little bit. It turned out pretty good. I had a lot of people there. Build up the server. I cruised around for 3 or 4 hours. RPM gauge is weird in this thing. Usually 1500 RPM straight up and down. This one's off just a little bit. He's making me think I look down there. I think I'm over revving it. Slow down and let some over and speed back up. Good way to lose the side of your car. £62,070 net weight.
Turn right.
Where to go if you're going? I don't know why you guys always fucking stop when the light changes. halfway through the curve. Let's see, lights are on, yep. Alright, get wound back up. Miles still yet.
Keep left.
There's a big old intersection, or fucking,
keep
can't left. Think of what the name of them are. Interchange, is that what the name of it is? I don't remember. Mine turned to mush. Yeah, this lane's about the end.
Keep left.
Keep left. Aeropuerto. No, you can tell what exit's coming up if you just, you can't tell in game because they don't have mile markers, but in real life you can tell by the mile markers because the mile marker and the exit will be the same. It can also tell you how much further you have to go in that state before you hit the state line by using the mile markers. Welcome to Socorro. Socorro. I don't think I've ever seen this skybox before. Pretty cool. Got the sunset off to the right of us there. Change it to outside view, but I'd run into this damn truck here beside me if I did. Come on over. I'm going to anyway. There's a sunset. El Paso. So which needle is the fuel and which needle's the death? There's two of them on the fuel gauge. I guess the red one is the regular diesel and the white one's the death. Yeah, that's what it looks like. $4.2 a gallon, it's going up. South, I believe that's what we're going to be taking. Or that's what we're on. Not bad. I thought 25 ran up through Colorado and Wyoming. Really, we should be in New Mexico? This is actually a pretty nice truck to drive. I thought we'd have to stop and get fuel on this trip, but I guess not. We still got over half a tank.
Keep left.
Keep left. Welcome to El Paso, everybody.
Keep left.
Keep left. I've been keeping left. Big city of El Paso. We should be getting close to our drop off.
Keep left.
Definitely ain't nobody out on the road, is there? It's 8:30 p.m. Got about 25 more miles.
Keep left and then turn left. Turn left.
X-Zone. Anytime now.
Keep right.
Keep right, she said.
Go straight on. Keep right, and then turn right. Turn right.
Damn, how far is this thing place out there?
Go straight on. Go straight on. Go straight on.
Thank you for letting me know.
Keep left, and then turn left. Turn left.
What the hell is that thing got the air hose thing on the dolly for? Not even hooked up. I ain't never seen that. We must be going way off in the industrial park. Or the hood. Where the hood at?
Keep left, and then turn left.
Keep left, turn.
Turn left.
Left. Come on, get in gear. We're going to the aeroport, though, aren't we? That's the reason it's far out here.
Keep right, and then turn right.
Yep.
Turn right.
This is FedEx.
This is where it ends.
This is where it ends. A lot of Gamer Donnie and Swift Raiders around here. Miles, 13 hours 29 minutes, 129.1 gallons of fuel consumed. We got $33,007, and we're level 43, a little 43, looks like it. So I hope you guys enjoyed our little trip we had. If you did, make sure you
don't forget to like, subscribe, share, and leave a comment down below. We'll see you in the next video. Have a great day.